Hello, I'm Abhishek Kunal. Welcome back to our CCNP route courses. In our next section, we'll be learning about our routing information protocol as part 2. In this section, first thing we'll be learning that is summarizations. Route summarization is a best way by which we can make our routing table to be very small. In our RIP routing protocol, we will do the task as such. Now in this network, we have got these loopbacks. Now if I'll come to my router number 5 over here, and if we will look after to my show IP route, then we can see that we are making a huge routing tables over here. How we can make it small enough? That can be done by our summarization rules. Summarization in our RIP can be done only on interface basis. As well as this summarization could be accomplished even in router number 2, or else in router number 3, or else on router number 4. It's a simple aggregation methods of our routes which we have got. So let's do this task in router number 2 over here, and then we will see the consequences. So we will do this task on router number 2 on interface fast Ethernet 0/1. So what it means, whenever router number 2 will get the updates from router number 1, it will be /24. Specifically for every 4 networks, but while sending the updates from our 0/1, it will be /22. As a consequence, it will come to router number 4 over here. In router number 4, the networks which it will be getting as updates will be /22 from this side, but still router number 3 will send that updates through /24. So router number 4 will consider the longest prefix match, and on that basis only it will install the networks in his routing table. So router number 4, now if we will look after the routing table of router number 4, it is taking as our load balancing over here. For every networks he is actually considering both the guys, but after doing the summarization in router number 2, router number 4 will only believe this particular way. So let's see the consequences, then we will resolve that problems. So we have to move to our interface level of fast Ethernet 0/1, and we have to put a command IP summary address for which distance vector protocol? For our RIP protocol. You can see that we have got the option of EIGRP. Now we have to do for only for RIP. So we will write over here IP summary address RIP. And if I'll do question mark, we will get the option of network address. So the network address for these loopbacks will be 1.1.0.0, and this network will go up to 3.0. So the specific mask we have to give over here, so that we can make them in one aggregate routes over here. So we will write over here 255, 255, 252.0 over here. Let's enter over here. Now if we will move to our router number 4, and if we will put the command show IP route, then you can see that we'll be getting some kind of updates as 1.1.0.0/22, but still we are going to route the packets only through router number 3. Now if I look after to 1.1.0 network, we can see that both the guys are present over here. Due to the low convergence of our RIP routing protocol, this thing will be not deleted very soon. If we will accomplish our clear IP route star command, that things will be deleted and only will be getting 1.1.0 network which we can reach through router number 3 side. Now after doing clear IP route star, when we are looking after to our routing table over here, now we can see that 1.1.0.0 network, we are going to that network through only router number 3. But even we are getting the summarized address from router number 2 side. We are not taking this part. Let's see this task with our show IP route specifically for 1.1.0 network. We are going to that network only through router number 3. So in these kind of cases, the sum rations could be a bad thing. So the sum rations should be done very properly. And if I want to make him as a solution, so in router number 3 we have to do summarization on our FastEthernet 0/0. So let's do that things. So what we will do, I'll go to router number 2, I'll copy the configurations and I'll paste this same configuration on 0/0 of router number 3. Done. Now if I'll move to router number 4 over here, and if we will try to clear the things, clear IP route star, and if I'll look after to my show IP route over here, we will be now doing load balancing properly. And the same updates will be updated to router number 5. Earlier router number 5 was making specific networks. So now if I look after to that things, after doing clear IP route star, and if I'll see my routing table again, now we'll be getting both the guys. After some bit of time, we will get both the things properly. So router number 5 can reach to these networks through router number 4, which we are getting, but not as we were getting earlier. When we will look after to the routing table previous time, so it was giving me these specific networks, but now we have made that networks in our aggregation kind of methods. Let's see whether it can reach to 1.1.0.1. Obviously it can reach to that things. Let's move with our next section, that is called our authentication. As we have already discussed that authentication can be done only in our version 2 with a two methods called, it could be clear text or it could be encrypted in the method of MD5. So let's do the first method of clear text. So we will do the authentication between router 4 and router number 5. But before doing authentication between them, we should know the rule of keychains. Keychain is a bundle of many keys, and a particular keys will be associated with a particular times and key IDs. So in router number 4 and router number 5, we have to make a same set of keys, and we will implement that keys on our interface and we will authenticate them. So while configuring our keychains, it can be done in this way. I will be writing keychain, and we can write any name over here also. We could write Cisco name. And then if we will come to our modes over here, now we are actually in our keychain modes over here. Now the next thing which we have to write over here is the key IDs now. We could actually configure these number of keys in one keychain. So these are the bundle of keys which we are configuring in our keychains. So I'll write over here keychain number 1. Now we are going to a specific key number in a particular keychain modes over here. Now we have to define a password over this side. So I'll write key string as a password. Key string should be written in this way, key hyphen string, and you can write the password. So I could write a password, a fancy name. I could write Cisco USA. So this is the password which I am writing, and the same set of password will be providing in router number 5 side also. Otherwise the authentication will be not applied properly. So what I'll do, I'll go and I'll write do show history over here. Whatever the things which we have written over here, I'll copy that things and I'll paste in router number 5 side. Done. Now on interface we will apply this key. So we will move to interface FastEthernet 0/0, and then we will write over here IP rip authentication. Now he will ask me a question that what keychain you want to apply. So the keychain is our Cisco which I'm going to apply over here. Apply this one. Now from router number 5 side we have applied the authentication, but still we are not applied the authentication from our FastEthernet 1/0 of router number 4. Now if we will try to debug the packets now, debug IP rip, we will be getting some kind of error messages. If we will look after to the packet now, we have ignored V2 packet from 10.1.45.4. What kind of problem it is? Invalid authentication, because in router number 4 we have not authenticated that things. So we have to go to router number 4 on a particular interface which is our FastEthernet 1/0. Over there we have to write same set of commands, IP rip authentication, which keychain we want to apply? It is Cisco over there. The name should be in our case sensitive kind of things. Okay, Cisco. Now we will not get any kind of problems and we'll be able to get the packets properly. Now you can see that we have received the packet with the text authentication of what things? Cisco USA. Now this particular password we could see from our command line. Even when we will trace the packet between router 4 and router number 5, it could be visualized over there also. So let's see that things with our Wireshark. This is the packet which we have captured between router 4 and router number 5. Let's open this packet. The authentication will be applied in our RIP protocol. So we will try to open this one. Now you can see that a new field will be added in our RIP packets as an authentication. What kind of authentication it is? It's a simple password. If we will try to open this packet now, we could see the password very properly. Cisco USA. So it's not a good practice to do the authentication with our clear text. How we could change that clear text to our MD5? Let's see that one. We will move to router number 5 again and let me do you all to every debugs now. Interface fast ethernet 0/0. We have to write this command IP rip authentication. If we will do question mark, we have got the option of mode. Now in the previous mode it was clear text, so by default it was text, but now I want to change it to MD5. Now in this case router number 5 is authenticated with MD5, but still router number 4 is authenticated with clear text. Still I'll be getting a problem over here. Let's witness that problem by debugging the RIP packets. Can see that we are getting some packet and we are ignoring that packet with invalid authentications. So we have to do the authentication properly in router number 4 side also. So let's do that things in our router number 4 by changing IP RIP authentication mode as MD5. Done. Now we'll be not getting these kind of error messages which we were getting in router number 5 earlier. Now you can see that receive the packet with MD5 authentication. We are not able to see the password Cisco USA. Let's see this behavior from our packet analysis. Now we have traced down one packet which is coming from router number 4. Let's open this packet. Now if I'll open my RIP packet over here, now the authentication is changed from clear text to keyed message digest. Now if we will open our authentication packet over here, we can see that we are not able to see the password. The password has been encrypted in this way. So Cisco USA has been changed to this encrypted methods. So this is a way actually we have to provide the authentication between two routers in our RIP. It's a good practice, but it can be applied only in version 2. Now let's go with our interface basis characteristics changing in our RIP. Now in our earlier section we have seen that when we were changing from version 1 to version 2, some interface level properties was also changed. But we can change that things specifically. Let's see that behaviors between router 4 and router number 5 again. Now to see the characteristics, first of all let's move to show IP protocols. Show IP protocols. Now if we will look after to the properties on interface of fast ethernet 1/0, we can send the packets with version 2, even we can receive the version 2 packets. But let it be, I want to change the interface level properties in this manner. What I'll do, I'll go to router number 5 and I'll change the version of this guy. I'll change the version 2 to version 1. So I'll write router rip over here and then I'll change to version 2. No, sorry, I want to change to version 1 over here. Now if I look after to my show IP protocols over here, now on the interface level, we are sending the packets with our version 1. But in our router number 4, we are only capable to receive version 2 packets. So now in router number 4, if we will try to debug the things, we will get some error message called illegal versions. Write debug IP rip. You can see that whenever we have got the packet from router number 5, we are coming into the problem called illegal versions. Now I want to change the properties on interface, so it can be done in this manner. I'll go to interface fast ethernet 1/0. We will write the command IP rip. And if I'll do a question mark over here, we will get the option of receive or send. Now I'll write over here receive. But one moment I want to make it as version 2 as well as version 1. So I'll write in this manner version 2, which is the by default characteristics of our interface basis. Then I want to make him as a version 1 also. We could do that things all the time, but it has to be done with our proper order of operations. So you could write over here IP rip receive with a version of 1 as well as 2 over here. Now we will not get these kind of problems. Now if I look after to my show IP protocols, now there is a change on a particular interface basis. What is the receiving things? What are the versions we could receive over here? But from our global point of view, we could send version 2 and we will receive only version 2. But on interface level, we are changing the properties. Now if I have changed the interface level properties, now from router number 5, we could receive the packets and we can install that networks properly. So this can be used very properly, guys. Now in the previous section, when we had applied our password between them, that things can be also witnessed with our show IP protocol command. Even we can change the advertisement interval on the interface basis. Now by default, what is the interval while sending the any kind of packet? It is around 30 seconds. But let it be, I want to make it fast between router 4 and router number 5. I want to make him as a 10 seconds. So it can be done by this method. We have to go to that interface 1/0. We will write over here IP rip. And if I'll do question mark, we'll write advertise what interval? 10 seconds. And this 10 second value will be applied only on fast ethernet 1/0. Even sometime I want to send the packet not on multicast address, I want to make it broadcast for version 2. So we can accomplish that things also by giving IP rip v2 broadcast command. Now in next section we'll learn about our passive characteristics. Passive interface in our rip tells us that we could receive the updates, but we will not send any kind of updates from that interface. It could be helpful whenever we have got any servers in our network, which updates I want to don't send in our network, but I could receive the updates. It can be done with a simple command called passive interface in our RIP configuration modes. So to do this task, I'll go to router number 5 and I'll make fast ethernet 0/0 as our passive interface. So I'll go to configuration mode to our router RIP mode over here, and then I'll write passive interface. Which passive interface? Fast ethernet 0/0. Now if I look after to our debug packets, router number 5 is able to receive the packets over here. But if we will look after to the networks routing table of these routers, we will be not able to receive the updates about this particular network. So let's see that behavior in every routers. We can witness that our router number 1 routing table, it is not able to find out 5.5.0 network, but we can see 10.1.45.0 network because router number 4 is updating about that network. Now when we will go to router number 5, let me UAL all the things, and if I look after to my show IP routing tables over here, we are able to receive all the packets over here. So this is the different characteristics which we have got in our RIP as in passive interface. Now in next section we'll be learning about our default network. Default network is a dynamic method of assigning the default route which is present in our network. Now in this topology which we have got over here, let it be we have got router 4 and router number 5 over here. This is our internet routes. Now these routers over here wanna go to internet, so obviously they require a default route to router number 4. Now that can be done by static method of default routing, but the same methods in our RIP can be done dynamically by assigning our default network. Default network can be done in many manners. So today we will learn about all the manners of making our default networks. So let's go with our first methods of making our default network. The first method is very much simple. We have to go to router number 4 over here, go to the configuration modes in a router RIP process, and we can write a command called default information originate. What will happen by giving this command, automatically every routers over here will get a static default route to router number 4. Let's see that behavior from router number 1 side. We will write over here show IP route. Now we can see that automatically we are getting a default route which is going up to router number 4. So let's check this particular features by doing a trace route to any arbitrary number 8.8.8. Ultimately we are reaching to our router number 4 over this case 34.4, or it could be 24.4 because we are doing a load balancing over here. So this is our first methods of assigning our default network. It can be also done by this method. We can make an arbitrary static route to ourselves by giving a destination address of null 0. So we can write over here IP route, we could write 67.89. Or else we can write in this manner also 192.168.5.0 255.255.255.0 is our class C network, and we could write that things up to null 0. So we'll write null 0 over here. Done. Now what will happen if I look after to my routing table show IP route, a static route has been created in our router which will go to the destination address of null 0, which is actually me. Now I have to advertise this network to our RIP over here, and in our RIP when we will advertise it will come as simple RIP route, but we have got the objective to change this simple RIP routes to our default networks. So let's first of all advertise this network. And another things which we have to understand over here, if it is coming directly connected, so in our IGP protocol we could advertise this network properly. So write router RIP, and then we'll write over here network 192.168, and what's the network we have got? 5.0. Done. Now if I look after to the router number 1 over here, show IP route, we will be getting this network very properly. Now we will again go to router number 4, and I have to change this networks to our default network behaviors. So we have to do these things from our configuration mode, not in our RIP mode. So we'll exit out from our RIP mode, and we will write the command IP default network over here. We have to not give gateway command. Gateway is only the feature for the non-routing devices. We'll write IP default network, and we will make him as 192.168.5.0. And the next thing which we have to see over here is that it will be applied only for the classful boundary networks only, because we have no any option of subnet mask. So we could write over here 172.16.0.5.0, and I have made it let it be in class C, and I've advertised that network. But that network can't be advertised with our default network because it will be in our classful boundaries. Now it is class C, and that class C boundaries only we are advertising that things with our default network. Let's do this one. And if I'll come to router number 1, earlier it was coming with R over here. Now if I'll again go and see that things, we'll be seeing that a new default route has been created over here. This is the second method of advertising our default route. But basically we form this kind of behaviors not by making an arbitrary number. We usually use this kind of networks always. We have to write IP route. We used to do with this one 169.254.0.0, which is our PIPA addresses. We know that this network is not routable. We don't use these kind of networks in our real scenarios. Let's delete all these configurations which we have provided over here by giving no to all these things. So I'll write Control A, copy this one, and paste these configurations. Now we will study about our new condition of making our default network. It is called as our conditional default network. Now conditional default network will work in this way. Now router number 4 is our base guy who will be providing me the internet service provider network. Now let it be this network goes off. So what will happen to the default network? Obviously that things will be maintained in every routers over here. Now for making ourselves not to come into that kind of problems, what we will do, whenever this network goes off, automatically the default network which we were advertising, that should be also deleted. It can be done by making our SLAs, and that SLAs will be associated with our tracking objects. So it can be done by two methods. So let's see one of the methods over here. First of all, I have to make a SLAs. So to make our SLAs, what we will do, we will write IPA select command, and if I'll do question mark over here, it will be giving me option that what is the number of SLAs. So I'll write IPA SLA number 1 over here, and if I'll do again question mark, okay, it's correct over here. Now we are in the prompt of SLAs over here. Now he will ask me a question, what kind of SLAs you want to make. So I will make a SLA called ICMP echo. Now by making this SLA, what will happen after a frequent seconds, we'll be always pinging to our router number 5. Now if router number 5 is replying to me, so the SLAs are in on condition. Now somehow router number 5, this interface goes off. So automatically the SLAs will be telling me that we are not able to go to router number 5, and that information will be going to router number 4. Router number 4 in that kind of condition will delete the default networks. So I'll write ICMP echo over here. Now he will be asking me a question, what is the destination IP address? So the destination IP address I have taken over here as 155.4.5.5 over here. Now he will be asking me a question, what will be the source IP, or it could be source interface. So I'll write over here source interface as fast ethernet 1/0 over here. Done. Now he will be asking me a question, after how many seconds I will be sending the ping packets. So I'll write frequency of 5 seconds over here. Now the task of making our SLA has been completed, but still we have not switched on our SLAs. To make it switched on, what we have to do, we have to write IP SLA, then we have to write the command schedule. Schedule for which number of SLA, we'll write SLA number 1, and then we will write down that it is going to start from now. So I'll write over here now. We could define the timings also. But the next thing which I have to define over here, what will be the life over here? So I'll write life should be forever. Now our SLAs are working very properly. Now the next thing is that we have to make our tracking objects. So to make our tracking objects, we have to write the command track, and if I'll do question mark over here, he will ask me a question, what is the number of the track? So I'll write track number 1 and I'll put a question mark. So I'll write over here what thing you want to associate this one. So I'll associate this one with our RTR, means it's our response time reporter, which we have made already as SLAs. So I'll write SLA number 1, and if I'll do question mark, we can actually define for the state, or the could be reachability, but up to this point it's right. Now if the SLAs are reporting that every packet is reaching properly, so the tracked object will be also switched on very properly. Let's see that behavior with our show track command. Now if I'll see my show track, state is up over here. This kind of reporting we are getting over here. Now if I'll come to router number 5, somehow I'll shut down this interface, then we will see the tracked object behavior. Now if I'll move to router number 5 and if I'll shut down that interface, fast ethernet 0/0, it will affect our router number 4. Let's see that behavior. Now I can see that our tracked object has been come to our down state. And if it is coming to down state, and the same thing if we will implement in our routing protocol, so it will affect our routing protocol, which can be informative for our default. This was our behavior of track. Now as I have told you that we can implement our track with any kind of objects, and if track goes off, it can inform our default networks to be deleted or it could be implemented. So let's see this behavior in our topology. In the topology, we have already made a track from router number 4. Now if I can see now, show track now. Now it is in up direction. In the previous time, it was in down condition when router number 5, first Ethernet 0/0, gone to down state. If I have shut it down, or it could be the property of protocols also. Now what I'll do, I'll make a static route over here, IP route. I'll take my APIPA address 169.254.0.0, and then I'll make a static route, and I'll send this back address as our null 0. Now I will implement that things with our track object over here. So I'll write track object I had made as track number 1 over here. Now in the earlier case, what I did, I had advertised this network 169.254.0.0 in our rip, and then we had written IP default network command by which router number 1, router number 2 and router number 3 was getting a dynamic default route. Now it can be done in the different manner. We can go to our router rip and we can redistribute our static route to our rip routing protocol. So we can write over here static, redistribute static. Then I'll write metric command, because if I'll not define the metric, the by default metric while redistribution will be infinite. So I'll write metric as, it could be 5 also, but not beyond 15, otherwise it will be considered to be the infinite metric. Now let's come to router number 1 over here, and if I'll see my show IP route over this side, we are getting that networks very properly. Now the next task which we have to do, we have to make this networks to be as our default network. So I'll go to router number 4, exit it out, and then I'll write IP default network over here, 169.254.0.0. As we have already discussed, it should be in our classful boundaries only. Done. Now if I'll see over here router number 1, and there's a creation of our default route very properly. So router number 1 will be getting the default route from both the side, two side, from router number 3 side also, from router number 2 side. Now what could be the effect now? Now let's come to router number 5 over here, and I'll disable our interface fast Ethernet 0/0. The moment I'll disable over here, what will happen to our track? Track will go to down, and the track has been implemented with our static route. So the static route will be also deleted. Now if the static route is deleted, obviously the default network will also come into the effects. So now our track is going to down state. Now if I look after to my show IP route over here, from our side, the static route has been deleted. Now if the static route has been deleted, obviously the default network will be also deleted. Let's see this behavior from our router number 1 side. After doing the clear IP route star, then only we can see that the default route is being deleted over here. So this is called as our conditional default route by our making our static route to be as our default network. Now in our previous section, we have seen that default network can be also made by command called default information originate. Now how we can use that things with our that things. To make it happen, what I'll do, I'll go to my router rip process again, and then we will write over here default information originate command. And if I look after to the question mark, we have got the option of route map. So we can use the concept of route map. In route map, I'll make the mapping with our static route, with our prefix list, or it could be with our access list. So let's first of all make our route map. So in our route map, what I'll do, first of all, I'll make a prefix list, IP prefix list. I'll write over here, it could be any name, I'll write NH over here, and then I'll permit. HOMAL permit 169.254.0.0, and then I'll define with our prefix length of 16 over here. Done. Then I'll create a route map. Route map name as India. India, and then I'll write permit for that guys. Then I'll match what thing? Match IP address, prefix list over here, prefix list NH over here. Now match IP address, prefix list NH. Now this route map I'll implement with our default information originate. If we will see the logics properly, the default information originate is calling a route map. Route map is calling our prefix list, and prefix list is calling our 169.254.0.0/16 network. And this network has been made with our static route, which has been called with our tracking. So it's a purely logical things which we are creating over here. Now let's move to our router rip command. There I'll write default information originate, and then I'll call this route map name India. It's a case sensitive thing, should be done very properly. Now I have written default information originate route map India, and the previous task what I did over here, I had made one IP default network. So let me delete that one, otherwise it will come and it will create a problem. So now what I'll do, I'll go to router number 5, I'll put no shutdown over here. Now if I've given no shutdown, automatically our track object will come into up direction. We'll wait for that things. Yeah, it's coming up. Now if it is coming up over here, if you will look after to my show IP route command, automatically our static route will be made over here. Now this static route has been implemented and has been called with our prefix list. And this prefix list has been called with our route map. And the route map has been called with our default information originate in our router rip subcommands. Now when we will come to router number 1, and if you will see my show IP route, we'll be getting that we are getting our default route properly. So logically speaking, in router number 4, we have gone with our continuous process of our route map, and that route map we made a scripting languages by which we are making our default networks. So it's our conditional default route example which we have done in our RIP protocols. So let's see what are the things we have completed up to this point. We have completed our default network, and I hope so it was informative for you guys. So up to this point we have done the configurations of our RIP with our basic and advanced concepts. So thank you from my side. Meet you in the next video.